to introduce the referees. We got Jamie LaBarge, Randy Lozier, and Jim Karen. Two out of three. So LaBarge and Mr. Lozier are fine viewer supporters for Hometown Cable. See Calvin Chastain at Plattsburgh State Field House. It's the second day of March 2018. And we're here for the Section 7 Class C Championship. So number one seeded defending champion, Northern Adirondack Bobcats. And from the MVAC, the Seton Catholic Lady Knights, who defeated the Oswego Valley Patriots to get here. Bobcats over the Ticonderoga Sentinels. This is the set with the ball. And all you Bill Chase fans, go up underneath. And got skip, nice skip. Nicole Bullock, no relation to Sandra Bullock as far as I know. All you Bill Chase fans, he is snowed in Boston. He was planning on being here, but he and Robin were in Boston. And we're supposed to fly back today, but this is March 2nd, 2018, the day of a big nor'easter that's hammering the shores of Boston. The high winds and a little bit of precipitation, but winds more than anything else, I think, is keeping the planes on the ground. And over in the western part of this state, the Buffalo area, Pennsylvania, they've gotten in some cases 2 feet of snow. That'll make it 4-2 in favor of Seton Catholic. This is LaBarge, gives to Chilton, rebounded by Zalis for the Knights. Plenty is Walker, Bullock, back to Walker, and also have Murnane, number 5 on the floor. And we have a foul on Reset. Yes, fouls on Reset. This is the middle game. It was Mariah over Westport in the opening game, and the next game will be Northeastern Clinton. And can't remember who they're playing. Air ball from Brooks. Bobcats take it away. Seton fans aren't happy with the no call. Let me tell you, Lambert played a heck of a game in Beekmantown. Defense is just like a cobra snapping at that ball. Reset sticks with it, throws it off the hand. It's a 6-4 Seton Catholic lead. Lambert will bring it up the floor for the Bobcats. So with all that weather going on in Boston and Buffalo, we have our ground covered with more snow in the Plattsburgh area than it was in the West Coast. The barge is down, but the Cats keep it. Chilton shot rebounded by Brooks. So we go back to Chilton. This time another one off the rim. Brooks is going to do this one again. This time I'll give it to Lambert, and it's blocked by Walker. No, it was Murnane with the block. I want to point out that I'm hoping that Bill Chase will be here tomorrow. I'm counting on getting Steve Chilton back here and hopefully Bill Chase to do the play-by-play. Bobcat boys are playing against Ticonderoga, and I've got regional hockey to cover up at Northeast up at Rouse's Point, actually. Regional. Cougars are already the sectional champions in a game that would send the winner to the Final Four, so it's a big game for the Cougars. So regional competition. They got to be there, and we're going to miss the Class D game for sure. And we're hoping to get coverage of the Class C game. We're set with a shot, air ball. Moran tries to save it, but can't do it. And the Bobcat ball, we're at 350. 4-6 to score. Lambert to LaBarge. LaBarge is tackled. Foul on Zalis, I believe. Ball's inbound to Brooks. Yeah. Jump ball, looks like. Wildcat ball. Goblin call. Walker into the set. 3.5 to go in the first. Seton Catholic looking for the upset win. They were the number 2 seed. They play in the MVAC. By size of school, they're actually Class D, but because they're a private school, they get moved up a rank. Blocked by Zale. Picked up by Walker, gives it to Reset. Under 3 to go, Reset tries a 3-pointer. Davis with the rebound, to block, and they're going to get a foul called. Joan picks up her first foul. Ken Bishy and Joan are here. Davis misses the first. But we'll bring it up with 7-4 Seton. LaBarge stops, pushes it back out. Going up by Lambert and rebounded Zales. Bullock. Walker, bounce pass, stolen by Chilton. Chilton has really become a dominant force this year, her senior year. Chilton and Zales, both members of the 1,000-point club. They know the secret handshake and everything. Here's Murnane, Reset. Bullock to Walker, to Murnane. Under 2, we have traveling call. 7-4 the score. And speaking of Bobcats, we want to thank Gary Castine for covering the end of the Bobcat boys game. I have to head here to the field house for hockey, so I did the first three quarters of the game. It's a jump ball. Come on, Jamie, show us how you can jump up and knock that ball down. There was a time, I'm sure, he could have done it. We have to leave Beekman Town to head here for hockey, and we did three quarters of the game, and Gary Castine finished up that game, then even stuck around to the season Ticonderoga game. So apparently it was Seton's turn on the possession arrow. Bullock off the back of the iron. Follows a shot nicely. Well done. And Nicole Bullock. Timeout for the Bobcats. They trail by 5 and 125 playing here in the first quarter. opens it up. I've written books in the back there. Bullock has got the job of trying to contain Seton. This is actually a smart move. Shot was up. Shot clock went off, but the shot was up. Foul call on Brooks. Instead of putting Zalis on Seton, and Zalis picking up fouls, and leaves Zalis free to move in for rebounds underneath. Lambert gets it to Seton. Poirier scores. Nice pass, nice look, nice job. Emily Poirier. It's a 9-6. It's a 9-7. 3-point play for Poirier. Walker down the floor to Monane, all alone, too hard. Front ball. Taylor LaBarge helping her back up. 20.6, Bobcat turn, chance to tie it or take the lead with a three. Mary Weinberg. You know, they just might be playing a box and one. Counted. 9-7. Nice leading. We'll have to pay more attention to our defense. It might be a boxing one. It might be one man-to-man on Seton and the others in the zone. We'll see when we come back. Walker inbound. Started by Seton. Offensive foul. Second. Stolen by Lambert. Seton for three. Poirier gets the rebound and two fouls. We can tie it with two. Poirier hits the first. Listen to the forecourt. From her name. Bobcat getting about her name. This time they pay for it. 11-9, Seton back in the lead. Lambert. Going away. By Marine. Bullock pulls up for a jumper. Rebounded by Brooks. Seton will bring it up the floor. Takes left, goes right, pulls up for a jumper off the rim. Zalis with the rebound. No set with a bounce pass up the Bullock. Underneath for Monane. Again, Monane beats everybody down the floor. And Bobcat trail by four, 15-9. Brooks. skating the ball. Coach Donna Dixon running out the advice. Into the hands of Perrier. Then back to Lambert. 6:20 showing in the half. Seton Catholic leading NAC. Off skip and a jump. Lambert rebounds, pushes it outside for Brooks. Perrier to Chilton. I think it's a man-to-man. Walker picks up her second foul. Labarge at the line. Tried to steal bullet from her name. Bobcats got to figure that out. That's six on the name's had this quarter. Another one from more than 3 feet away from the basket. 6 points, that is, three buckets. No travel. Yep. Now that I look at the score, I think they had 9 coming into the half to the quarter. They're 16 now, so I'm thinking that all 6 Seton points this quarter have been scored by Murnane. Ball up to inbound. Has to get it over Pollo doing her exercises. Up the ball. Make it a 6 point Seton Catholic lead. Seton stays. Double triple team with the shot off. Labarge, first court, knock loose. Walker can drop with it. There's your set. We thought about it. From the jump, the jumper from the elbow, banks it in. Bullock off the window. And it's an 8 point Seton Catholic lead. 19-11. Thrown in by Labarge. 19-13. Bayless. At the side of the backboard. Labarge rebounds. Lambert brings it up. Under 4 to go in the first half. Seton up 19-13. 6 point lead. Brooks. Traveling called. We're set with the ball. Here's Chilton. Lambert shot. Rebounded by Velas. 19-13, it's 3 minutes to go in the half. If that shot is blocked by Chilton. There's Lambert into the forecourt, 248. Catholic playing tenacious defense. Chilton wanted the ball in the paint. Has to post up against Bullock. They go for the short jumper. 19-15. There's Bullock. Zalas. And he lays it in. That's a 21-15. I think that bank shot by Bullock is the first shot that the Knights have taken that went in. Everything else has been the equivalent of a layup. And Seton gets the ball. Bullock. Over to Walker. 1:36 to go in the half. Bullock shot rebounded by Chilton. Chilton slides through, throws it up and in. And the shot is hurt. Back on her feet. The second foul. Chilton will try to make it a three-point play. And a three-point deficit, and she does. Timeout for the Knights. They're up 21-18 with 1:24 on the clock. Three-point ball game. Somebody's got to inbound it. Walker will toss it into Reset. 1:22 on the clock. 21-18 the score. Reset to Walker. Reset for three. No. Rebound LaBarge. Bounces it to Chilton. Chilton pulls up for the jumper. It's short. But there for the rebound is LaBarge. No foul. New foul, and apparently it was off blue. Lambert to inbound. Off Walker. Lambert to inbound. 55.6 on the clock. Chilton. Rolls it in. 21-20. 40 seconds to go in the half. A one-point ball game. Section 7, Class C Championship at stake for 2018. Ball comes up short. LaBarge hands it to Poirier. Poirier pushes it up to Chilton. Chilton gives it to Poirier. Off the iron. Good hustle there, rebounded by Brooks. Chilton for three, yes. Three-bagger by Paige Chilton. And it's a 23-21 lead for Northern Adirondack. 6 seconds to go in the half. The shot throws up a desperation heave. They're unable to get the shot they wanted. So if it comes from behind, 23-21 lead for Northern Adirondack. The defending champions are up by two at the half here on viewer-supported hometown cable. It's Bobcat ball. They have a two-point lead And the ball to start the second half here on viewer-supported hometown third base at Seton. Lambert tucks it in. 25-21. Here's Reset. Bullet. Short. Rebound pulled down by Labarge. She'll give it to Lambert. It's like a zone now for Seton. And that's Seton scores. And that's a 6-point Bobcat lead. There's the set. Oh, what's the call? Travel. Looks like it was all bad from here, so it's a good call. Lambert gives it to Labarge. She gives it to Brooks. Chilton. All bad. I think Perrier might have been able to save it, except Brooks got a hand on it trying to save it herself. And I'm trying to think if anybody has substituted yet. I don't think so. I think there's been no subs in this game at this point. Off blue. We'll bring it up. 6:20 on the clock. Travel. This is set. Walker to Reset. Zayas. Knights have got to get Zayas into the offense, and they did that time. They get their first second half point. 27-23 as Lambert brings it into the forecourt. Seton Catholic's turn on the possession arrow. With the refs. Oh, it took 2 seconds off off the shot clock with that whistle stoppage. Bullet. And they're set with a shot. Bullet gets the rebound. Off blue. Under 5 to go. Set the shot clock on a kick? Apparently not. 17 on the shot clock. Grab it to inbound. Off blue. Wow. I think I'd have to look at that one again. Obviously, referee Karen saw something I didn't see. Doesn't mean he's wrong or I'm right, but I sure didn't see it. Lambert with his fast fingers. Bobcat lead at 4 points, 4:15 on the clock here in the third quarter. Brooks. It's a back, pulls up for a jumper and drops it in. Brooks makes it 29-23. We're at the 4 minute mark. A shot with the ball. Rebounded by Poirier. Robard hits the first and second is off the rim. Davis with the rebound. 30-23. Round it down, slow to get up. Bullock. 30-26. Back out to Brooks. There's Poirier. Pushing says Randy Lazer. 30-26 Bobcats. Another second foul of the second half, one on each team. 3-pointer would make it a 1-point game. If it's a traveling call or what, we're going to go to the timeout. Lambert will toss it into Brooks. And Lambert will bring it up. Stolen. Lambert name. Carrying the ball. Brooks will inbound to Lambert. 2:18 on the clock. Poirier. Brooks to Seton. Brooks in the corner. Nice job of rebounding there by Emily Poirier. Seton shot, rebounded by Bullock. Knights down by four. 1:33 to go in the third. Walker. The set. Six on the shot clock. That was up. That was up, but it didn't hit the rim. The Bobcat ball with 1:19 in the third quarter. Elbow. Seton drops in. 32-26 with 53 seconds in the third. Bullock. This is off to Murnane. No. Jump ball. Bobcat turn. Good. 30 seconds to go in the third. 22 on the shot clock. The ball will be called for travel. The Knights will look for the last shot. They're down by six. That'll do it. Knights are going to have to find a way to get Zalis into the offense. Meanwhile, a nice third quarter for the Bobcats. They lead by six after three here on viewer-supported hometown cable. Team Catholic ball. By Chilton. Intended for Zalis. Blocking foul on the set. That's third foul. Zalis takes it away. Bullock. Up to the set. Off the run. Rebound. Poyo. Out to Chilton. Poyo to Chilton and a nice move by Chilton. 8 point Bobcat lead, 34-26. Is Lissette. Walker. Off the rim, rebounded Chilton. Lambert will bring it up the floor. Chance to make it a 10-point lead. By Lamar, is it good? Oh, trailing 36-26. The Knights call a timeout. 6:45 left in the game. Bobcats will shoot. Rebounded by Zalis. 36-26. Bullock pulls up for a quick jumper. 26-28. There's Lambert. Seton. All guarded by Zales. Rob underneath. Gets the ball to Labarge. Labarge makes it a 10-point lead again. There's the set. Foul on Brooks. Second foul on Brooks. Reset hits him. Here's a 3-point shot. How about that? We got a three. Seton fans wanted the travels. Seton gets the rebound. The ball is just swatted away by Zales. Down the floor for Manane. Six-point game. 38-32, 5.5 to go. Labarge. And the set. Bullock will bring it up. Knocked out of bounds by Poirier. Lambert almost had the steal. Bayless. Under 5 to go in the game. Lambert. Their own rebound. Gives it to Labarge, and Labarge puts it in. 40-34. What's that? Air ball, pulled down by Labarge. Over to Seton. Four 16 left in the game. 40-34. Six-point block. That was fouled. Lambert's first foul. Approaching the 4-minute mark. For a second foul, Zales will shoot. Five-point game, 40-35, 3:40 to go. Lambert. Picks it up. back to Lambert. Trenton turns, spins, drops it in. I think that was Trenton with the block. Another jump ball. Bobcat turn. Seton Catholic climb out. Down by seven. With 3:07 to go. remaining. Knights provide full court pressure. And they get the steal. Number 3 to go. Bullet. Bullet for foul. Second foul. Yeah. 42-36. 2:46 on the clock. Front ball. Blue turn. Pick him up at midcourt. Lambert into the forecourt. Fairway. Falls in. Remember that basket if it's a two-point game. It came that close to bouncing out. Fairway put it in for a four-point lead. This is for three. Bobcat turn on the possession arrow, 44-40, 1:34 to go. Find the Knights will put full court pressure on. Foyer up to Seton, 23 on the shot clock. Seton drives. Davis rebound. Another bonus, so Zales will shoot two. The foul's on Lambert, her third. 44-41. 46-322 in the OT. Seton gets the shot up. Rebound Zales. We're set into the forecourt, under three now. Zales. Zales looking for the three-point play. They'll settle for two. There's Seton's third foul. So Seton with the rebound. And it's a foul. Seton gets Zales in the air. Zales is third foul. It's the second, so 1 point game. There's Bullock. We're set to Zales. Catholic ball, 2:21 remaining in the overtime. Knights up by one. Willis forces up a shot. Rebounded by Chilton. First foul on Moran. They have another chance to tie it here. 1:56 remaining. They're tied, 48-all. That's it. Just across in time in the 10 seconds. Time on the shot clock. Jump ball. jump ball. 1-0-2 to go, Seton's ball. They lead by two. And the bullet. With the Murnane. And the story of the game. Seton is fouled. You'll see two. Walk up, no, Bullock puts up her third. Catch a 3-for-6 from the foul line here in the overtime. It's 12-3. And a set to Galus. Again, just barely across in time. And goes out of bounds. A 3-point lead, however, for the Knights for 29.2. A 2-pointer won't do it. For the Bobcats, they trail by three. Lambert. And Portfolio. I believe it's on Brooks, the third, I think. No, it's on 30, LaBarge, the first. What's that? Make it a two possession game. You can drop one of these in. Four-point difference. 23.2 on the clock. Timeout. About that. Lambert the inbox. Remember, you're watching viewer-supported local television. The only thing that we have is if viewers step up and support our efforts. I'm not aware of any Seton Catholic families that are currently supporting us. Maybe now is the time of several Bobcats. Bullock. And a half to go. Stop that clock with the two possession lead. A 6-point lead. Oye for three, no. Rebound. Bravo. 2.8. Seton Catholic. the night. They've defeated the Bobcats. And a new Section 7 Class C champions. '45-49 in overtime. Congratulations to the Seton family, the Lady Knights. They're the Section 7 Class C champions for 2018. You're watching viewer supported local television, Hometown Cable. Win, lose, or draw to be worthy of your support, Hometown Cable. Thank you for watching.